Oshawa is a city, and as soon as I came to the city of Oshawa, I realized I should follow my dreams.
People talk about us as you know, the schwa. I hate that word.
Yeah.
But it's a word that, you know, if you grab it and you address the issue, you know what, call me the schwa. Show me your art gallery. You know, we have behind me the Robert McLaughlin Gallery, which has one of the fifth largest collection of publicly owned art in Ontario, owned by the residents of Oshawa. We own the largest collection of painters, 11 in the world within that gallery, 1,100 pieces.
I'm originally from Toronto and I moved here with my family when I was 4 years old and have lived in Oshawa since. My favorite thing about the city is definitely the university that we have here, the University of Ontario Institute of Technology. Coming here has really allowed me to find myself and grow personally. Coming from the amazing friends I've made to the support I've gotten from faculty and friends, they've really pushed me to chase my dreams and go after what I really want. And as a result of all the opportunities I've had here to grow and really find who I am, I've been able to accomplish a major goal of mine, which would be being accepted into medical school. And so today I'm proud to say that I am accomplishing my goals and my dreams, and I have the city to thank for that.
I've been watching you for some time. Can't stop staring at those ocean eyes. Burning cities and napalm skies. 15 flares inside those ocean eyes. Your ocean.
This is my city. I truly stand behind it. One thing I really enjoyed about growing up in Oshawa is that we had a really amazing track, and this is at the Civic Auditorium. I remember competing at my elementary school and being able to compete with like-minded athletes in a sport that I loved, and at this point it was track and field. I've been always involved in athletics, and I find this really important for human growth. The Civic Auditorium got rebuilt, but I remember when it was asphalt and, you know, doing my 100 meter dash and just having the fun that I did as a kid. It was cool, you know, you know, being on the race lane, you know, hearing the crowd, hearing everybody from the school cheering you on, and it really made you feel alive inside, and you really want to perform at your best.
So I was born in Oshawa, Ontario. I've been here for about 21 years. And it's super cool how I've watched this town go from just a little town that no one really knew about to this amazing town that everyone knows about. All the construction that's been going on, we're really striving to make Oshawa great, and I think we're really succeeding. Normally, Toronto is the place to go to for modeling, or New York, but I was actually scouted in Oshawa by a small boutique agency, and that kind of started my career, so to say. So I do that full time. I've done lots of campaigns, lots of commercials, movies, TV shows. So it's really exciting that you can do all of that from what used to be a small town, Oshawa. Cause it's a white noise, swallow it me. Taking your high horse, and I'll be free.
Since we were in business since 1922, and the people in downtown have been, in Oshawa in general, have been wonderful to us. You look around, you've got, right beside us is the new hotel.
You'll have people who spend hundreds of thousands of dollars to get you in their store. You'll come in their store, they don't greet you, they don't look at you, they treat you like a piece of dirt, and expect you to come back. We do exactly the opposite. Once you get into the store, we like to greet you, we like to look after you, and we'd like you to come back.
And in the course of this interview and talking to you, you've seen a few customers come through, and almost all of them we know by name. And that bodes well for us, because these people know us by name too. I think that's how you continue to do well in business, is you look after your customers.
A connection.
Yeah, absolutely. And ever since that time, I've been burning bright fire deep inside. I just want to feel your love. I need your love. Wake me back to life. Give me
city, all I can say is that I love to create. All I need is a camera and a lens.
To me, Oshawa is, it's a city in motion, right? It's a lot more than violence and drugs and crack cocaine and low development housing. It's actually a place where people grow, because we've been in such a low place, you know what I mean? I've been to a lot of schools in Oshawa. I never really had a lot of stability in my life. So me going to college was a big step for my family and for myself. I'm glad to be born and raised here. I'm a prodigy of the Shawa, you could say. the shwiggity, whatever you guys want to call it these days. And I just want to emulate a good image for Oshawa, you know? I want to project Oshawa to be almost Toronto.
We have people from around the world come to Oshawa to look at what we have. We've entertained people from China, Brazil, Cuba, Italy. We have consulate generals stopping in all the time. U.S. ambassadors have been to town to look at what we have here and to look at our schools and where we're going. You know, within the middle of our hospital, we have one of the best cancer centers in all of Ontario, but we also have a campus dedicated to Queen's University students called the Learn Center, where it is automated to the point where the mannequins blink and talk and have a pulse, and you can create one of the most interesting days in a future doctor's life, right in a setting within a hospital. It is amazing to watch. It's exciting. We're bringing some of the youngest and brightest minds in this country are coming to Oshawa to go to school, whether it be at the Learn Center in Lake Ridge Health or UOIT, Trent or Trent's partnership with the University of Windsor or Durham College. We have the second largest ground source heating complex in all of Canada is located in Oshawa at the University and the College. We're home to the world's largest climatic wind tunnel, and if you want to see the wind tunnel in action, Google Rick Mercer and his experience.
Yeah, I've actually seen that, yeah.
And a Camaro convertible built in Oshawa.
I'm going 140 kilometers an hour! 180!
Go over 2. What? Go over 200! You're not going to get a ticket here.
I'm going 203 kilometers an hour! This is so cool! What's this button do?
Not a good idea.
Okay, I don't know. Where's the manual? I can't find the manual! Open the glove box!
Those are stories that people don't know.
But I believe in what I see. And when I close my eyes, I see my whole life ahead of me.
For me personally, I love Oshawa. I've lived here my whole life. Growing up, my childhood experiences were really incredible. I'm actually going to school in Toronto right now, and every time I come back, I feel that sense of being at home. I feel that sense of that community that Oshawa has, and it's just so unique and so different than anywhere else. Oshawa is just going to keep improving on little things and keep getting better. I feel like even with the mall, as they hire about 700 people, employment rate's going to keep going up. There's going to be more opportunities for jobs, and even just youth employment is going to increase more and more. Out on the verge of the rest of our lives tonight, top of the world, and we're dressed to the nines tonight, edge of the earth, and we're touching the sky tonight, out on the verge of the rest of our lives. These are ours. This is our.
One thing that most people don't know about is just like the scenery. You come to Oshawa, especially the north end, it's just beautiful. Like, as a realtor, I have nothing but respect for the architecture out here, the landscaping, the natural effect of everything. It's just crazy. You come here, it's not like the city, you know, it doesn't have all that constant distress, that feeling. You know, you come out here, you get the feeling of, you know, I'm not too far from amenities, but, you know, I get the fresh feeling in the air, you know what I'm saying? I feel like I'm away from it all, the craziness. I can relax out here, and I think that feeling brings a great peace of mind to most people live out here. And it's kind of unusual at first, especially coming from the city, wherever you're from. But once you adjust, it's hard not to come back. It's crazy.
also home to Parkwood, the founder of General Motors of Canada, Colonel R.S. McLaughlin's estate.
Just one look at you, I saw the truth. Just one look at you, and I crashed into my love. Washed up, young blood. Washed up. Do what you want, I'll pull my punches. Say what you want, louder than any sound. Feel what you feel, I'll do no better than you. Around. Feel what you feel, I'll do no better than you. All my life. Lost in love, washed up together. Lost in love, washed up together.
He was in the heart of our city. He was a big part in the history of the automobile in Canada. Longest serving honorary colonel of the Ontario Regiment. Longest serving member of the board for General Motors. And his vision and his dream for a city of world-class caliber was Oshawa. And you can see his name not only on buildings in our community, but on buildings throughout Canada. The name for Oshawa, and they called it the Schwa, but you know, call us the Schwa. But go to your own community and look to see what you have.
It's kind of resembling what's going on in Ontario. It's a culture hub. It's got so many nice trees, so many nice locations that you can go to. It's not quite the city, but it is a city.
And as a city, you know, if you want to give something back to this community, give us 1 hour a year. You know, if you look in the city, and you know, we have 20,000 young students in this community going to school here, and if they each would give just 1 hour on one day, one time a year, well, we could do some great things here. The gift of service to your community is amazing.
I love passion.
It's something that everybody in the city has. And if we all come together, we can do extraordinary things.